Hello and welcome to the video. Boys Are Back in Town by Thin Lizzy, off their 1976 album Jailbreak, their biggest hit and their biggest, most successful album. Scott Gorham, one of two Thin Lizzy guitarists from their classic lineup that recorded this album and their other more successful albums. It said he remembers being at Phil Lynott's house with him and they were going over songs for the Jailbreak album. Then at the end of the session, Phil just broke out this bass line and said, "What do you think?" And it was just the bare bones of it at that point. The next day at rehearsal, Brian Downey and Brian Robertson joined in the songwriting process. Brian Downey came up with the shuffle drum beat, which gave Scott Gorham the kind of idea for the harmony that you hear now, that's a really recognisable part of the song, but they didn't record it just yet. They had an 8-track recorder in the rehearsal space, so they did a rough demo of what was called at the time G.I. Joe, or G.I. Joe's Are Back in Town. It was an anti-war kind of protest song at that point. The band's manager, Chris O'Connell, listened to 15 songs that they demoed, out of which they needed to pick 10. And G.I. Joe, they'd already rejected because they didn't think it was good enough for the album. But he listened to it and he thought there was something there. Even in its pre-harmony form, Chris O'Connell picked up on it and suggested that they do take it further, even though it needed work. It still wasn't there lyrically because the anti-war thing didn't really fit in with Thin Lizzy's style at that point, but the band accepted his judgment and went with it. The Boys Are Back in Town didn't even make it into the short list of 10 songs that they wanted to record for the Jailbreak album because of time restrictions back then. You had to pick 10 songs to fit onto the vinyl. The song didn't get fully realised until they went into the studio to begin working on the Jailbreak album in late 1975, South London's Ramport Studios. They didn't even have the title, The Boys Are Back in Town, at this point. And then one day Phil came into the studio and he changed the title to The Boys Are Back in Town, changed the lyrics, and that's what you hear now. Scott Gorham picked up on them and he was like, "Yep, this is good, let's go with this." That's when Gorham and Robertson came up with the harmony in the middle of the song that's so famous. G.I. Joe turned into The Boys Are Back in Town. There's no belief from the bands that that song could become a game changer for them. It's all owed to two disc jockeys in Louisville, Kentucky, who took the track and just wouldn't stop playing it until other radio stations surrounding caught onto it and then it spread across America. And suddenly, in the middle of their tour, the manager burst into the dressing room saying they've got a hit, and they were all looking around going, "Well, what song is it?" And he said, "The Boys Are Back in Town." And Phil turned around and said, "Well, we better put it back in the set then," because they weren't even playing the song on the tour at that point. That's how little belief they had in it. And at that point, the record company Mercury in the United States, who Thin Lizzy were under, decided to put it out as a single. Of course, they say that they knew all along that they'd do that, and they take the credit for it. But that's not the way it was. Dino's Bar and Grill, standout lyric in the song. On Sunset Boulevard, unfortunately now gone. In between the Whiskey and the Right House, if you know your rock and roll history. Was connected to 77 Sunset Strip. Scott Gorham once said that America hit Phil like a ton of fish. This song is a product of that. It's the first time I ever went to Dublin. First time I ever went to Ireland, straight off the plane, I went to visit his grave. It was the first thing I did. I had to go and pay my respects to the big man. I left behind my mates, we were all over there on a stag do, and just made my pilgrimage. Another band that I'm a huge fan of. And this is a crossover tattoo between Phil Lynott and the Irish folk legend Cú Chulainn, who talks about in the song Black Rose. So if you know your Irish mythology, and if you know your Thin Lizzy, then you'll understand all the different parts of this tattoo and what they mean. There's sort of little hints of different things in there. So as well as being a great songwriter, charismatic frontman, great voice, Phil Lynott was also a great bass player. Problem being, in this song, the bass is really buried, so you don't really get to hear exactly what he's doing. But luckily, managed to figure it all out, score it all out, so you can see exactly what he's doing. So pay attention. So this is what he does in the first verse. In the chorus. Underneath the guitar harmonies is the simplest part. I think he lay back there to let the guitarist take the spotlight. In the second verse. Second chorus, the bridge. Third verse, third chorus. The bridge. And then the outro. There you have it. There's a lot going on. A really nice bass line. If you want to learn it properly, get in touch. Follow the links below. Get my contact details. Give this video a like. Give my channel a subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.